Happy learning.
Hi, welcome to the second series of BPharm 5th semester exam notes and exam preparation. This series is related to the antihypertensive drugs. The first question is classify antihypertensive drugs. It is diuretics, particularly thiazide diuretics, sympathoplegics, which reduce the sympathetic outflow. It is of drugs inhibiting central sympathetic outflow, that is alpha 2 agonists and beta 1 antagonists, ganglionic blockers, trimethoprim, adrenergic neuron blockers, reserpine, pritelium, and guanidine. Adrenergic receptor antagonists, alpha 1 antagonists, beta 1 antagonists, and combined blockers, alpha 1 and beta 1 blockers. Vasodilators, potassium channel openers, hydralazine, minoxidil, diazoxide, nitric oxide releasers, hydralazine, sodium nitroprusside, dopamine agonist, phenyldopam, calcium channel blockers, amlodipine, pelodipine, nifedipine, renin angiotensin aldosterone system inhibitors, renin inhibitors, aliskirin, angiotensin converting enzyme inhibitors, they are prils, and angiotensin receptor blockers, they are sartans. Next is, it is a short note on angiotensin converting enzyme inhibitors. The list, there are many prils in this, captopril, enalapril, lisinopril, perindopril. You can remember any number of prils which you can memorize. Mechanism of action, they prevent the generation of angiotensin 2 and from the angiotensin 1, and they reduce the blood pressure. All angiotensin converting enzyme inhibitors are prodrugs except two drugs, that is captopril and lisinopril. Captopril is least potent and having fast action. Perindopril is the longest acting, whereas captopril is the shortest acting ACE inhibitor. Enalaprilat, it is an active metabolite of enalapril. Separately, enalaprilat is available for IV in treatment of hypertensive emergencies. Other drugs are administered orally. Therapeutic uses of angiotensin enzyme inhibitors are multiple. They are treatment of hypertension, congestive heart failure, evolving myocardial infarction, diabetic nephropathy, diabetic retinopathy, and scleroderma crisis. Adverse effects, dry cough, angioedema, abnormal taste sensation, and hyperkalemia. They increase the levels of bradykinin, that leads to prominent dry cough. Drug interactions with the calcium channel blockers and diuretics, they increase the antihypertensive action of ACE inhibitors. ACE inhibitors with NSAIDs, it reduces the antihypertensive action of the ACE inhibitors. With lithium, it increases its toxicity. With potassium sparing diuretics, there is a risk of hyperkalemia. It should not be combined. These drugs are contraindicated in pregnancy and when the serum creatinine level is more than 3.5 mg per 100 ml. Angiotensin receptor blockers, they may ask a separate question. All the indications are same as angiotensin converting enzyme inhibitors. They are all sartans, losartan, valsartan, telmisartan, azlisartan, and therapeutic uses, they are very similar and they are well tolerated. They don't have dry cough, angioedema, and abnormal taste sensation, but they can cause hyperkalemia. These are alpha blockers. Classification is non-selective alpha blockers. They block both alpha 1 and alpha 2, phenoxybenzamine, pentolamine. Alpha 1 selective blockers, prazosin, terazosin, doxazosin, alpuzosin. Alpha 1A blockers, damsulosin and celodosin. Therapeutic uses, phenoxybenzamine, it is used to prevent hypertensive episodes. In case of pheochromocytoma, it is an adrenal tumor. Pentolamine and tolazoline are agents which are used in hypertensive emergencies in case of clonidine withdrawal and cheese reaction from serotonin syndrome. Papaverin, pentolamine induced penile erection therapy for impotence. Adverse effects are postural hypotension and marked tachycardia. Selective alpha 1 blockers are the drug of choice for hypertension and benign prostate hyperplasia. They are useful in treatment of scorpion sting also. adverse effects are postural hypotension. They actually occur at the earlier stages of the dosing. That's also called first dose effect. It can be resolved by continuous use of these drugs. Inhibition of ejaculation is another adverse effect. It is seen with all the alpha 1 selective blockers. Selective alpha 1A blockers are two drugs, tamsulosin, celodosin. They are useful only in case of benign prostate hyperplasia. They don't have effect on the blood vessels. They don't cause postural hypotension. Adverse effects are intraoperative floppy iris syndrome, which occurs during cataract surgery. It is about sodium nitroprusside. It's a arteriovenodilator. It has to be, its solution has to be prepared freshly because it is unstable. Actually, it increases the nitric oxide from the endothelium, releases, increases the cyclic GMP by stimulation of guanyl cyclase. All these things cause vasodilation. Therapeutic uses, it is short acting. It is useful only in case of hypertensive emergencies, particularly to have a controlled hypertension during acute mitral regurgitation and refractory congestive heart failure. Adverse effects, because it is short acting, when you use it for a longer time, it can cause renal disease, cyanide toxicity, CNS toxicity, intracranial hemorrhage, and hypothyroidism can occur. It is contraindicated in pregnancy. Methyl-DOPA, it is a prodrug that is structurally similar to L-DOPA. It is it crosses the blood-brain barrier. It is converted to an active metabolite, alpha-methyl-norepinephrine, which is an alpha-2 agonist. It is useful antihypertensive. It reduces the peripheral vascular resistance. It is useful in treatment of mild to moderate severe hypertension. It is safe in antihypertensive. It is the most safe antihypertensive in pregnancy. Adverse effects, sedation, lethargy, weight gain, fluid retention, nasal stuffiness. In some patients, it may cause hemolytic anemia. They may answer for positive Coombs test. Alpha-methyl-DOPA, when clubbed with tricyclic antidepressants, it can reduce the antihypertensive effect of alpha-methyl-DOPA. Then clonidine, it is also a alpha-2 agonist. It decreases the central sympathetic outflow. It is useful in treatment of hypertension and prophylaxis of pregnancy. It is safe in pregnancy. Its adverse effects are similar, dry mouth, sedation. Sudden stoppage may cause rebound hypertension. Hydralazine, it is a vasodilator with a dual mechanism of action, potassium channel opener and nitric oxide releaser. It is used orally for treatment of severe hypertension. It is metabolized by acetylation. Fast and slow acetylators have a variable effect on this. Fast acetylators have reduced therapeutic effect. Slow acetylators are prone for adverse effects of hydralazine, that is systemic lupus erythematosus. Hypotension may also occur. Minoxidil, it is a prodrug activated to minoxidil sulfate. It's a vasodilator, potassium channel opener, given orally for treatment of severe hypertension. Adverse effects are hypotension and hirsutism. Because of hirsutism, the solution of it, topically it is used for treatment of male pattern baldness or alopecia areata. So it's a short information of all the antihypertensive drugs which could be useful for your exam point of view. I hope it will be useful for you. Thank you for listening. Happy learning. Kindly share this to more of your friends. Kindly subscribe to our Pharma Topics channel for further updates. Kindly go through all the series and make use of it. Thank you.